Automotive Agile PEP 2017. It's a pleasure to be here with Erik Knaus. Welcome.
Yeah, pleasure to be here. Thanks.
Thank you. Would you like to introduce yourself, your professional background?
I'm an associate professor at University of Gothenburg and Chalmers University of Technology in Gothenburg in Sweden. And I'm working there in the software engineering division, both on agile methods and on requirements engineering processes.
So what does agile mean to you?
When I was a PhD student and also that myself a student, I was getting in touch with agile methods. I was getting very excited around the year 2000 on these things, and from there on I've always followed it, and have tried to find the best ways to teach it to students, but also the best ways of helping people to introduce it in industry. So for me that has always been a journey of applied research, and now it's really exciting to see how this is moving towards the automotive companies.
What impact do you think agile methods have on the automotive industry?
Yeah, well, the automotive industry is realizing, of course, now for quite some time that a lot of value is generated with software. And I guess that agile methods will help to really focus on software and get the best out of the software development and really speed up those parts and create a lot of value. So it supports their transformation into software companies.
So what do you think are the most common failures when it comes to developing agile projects in different companies?
It starts, I guess, from a big flaw in the agile in the way we see the agile world, right? So we have no clear definition. We don't know what is agile, what is not agile. So in that sense, there's a lot of very different opinion, and I guess what would be very wrong is cling too much on something that can be read in books, but we need to interpret, of course, within a given context on what we need to do here. And that is, we need to be really creative in how to apply agile methods.
So you're a professor at the university in Gothenburg. What is the impact of agility in your daily job as a professor at university?
Of course, I have courses on agility, and I think throughout our whole software engineering programs, all the project work of our student is agile. Mm-hmm. I guess what I notice is what has changed a bit in the past few years is our students do not know anything else but agile.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, like when I was starting to teach agility, I guess I could always contrast and say, okay, in a traditional waterfall you do it like this, mm-hmm. now you do it like this. This is not going to work anymore. Our students only know agile, and I think this also sets the expectation if they get hired by automotive company. Mm-hmm. They want to work this way.
Being here at the conference, what are you hoping to take away with you at the end of the day?
It's really interesting to see how all the companies are currently struggling to implement those concepts, not only on a team level, but really on the complete organization level. And I think they're struggling on different sides. They also kind of have different views on what should be agile, what not. So it's really very interesting to see, and it's an awesome group of people coming together here.
What about new things and trends? What do you think are current trends when it comes to agility in the automotive industry?
I guess it's more going towards autonomous teams, about teams that have a responsibility on their own, I guess. And this is something we need to manage, because then the teams are generating knowledge on all kinds of levels.
Mm-hmm.
So how to create a shared knowledge in a company, I think that will be really interesting.
Mm-hmm.
I guess in agility I see there's a trend towards more automation, and with that it's not so much like it was so much of a grassroots endeavor, like a lot of developers say, okay, we don't need those tools, we just build software. Now it is a lot of automation.
Mm-hmm.
We see that in continuous integration and continuous deployment.
Mm-hmm.
So perhaps, you know, like agility is in a way a word, but we need to find good ways to be flexible and to support the processes that we want.
Mm-hmm.
I guess in that sense, the trend is at the moment going a lot towards automation.
You're also going to hold a session on later today. Could you give us like a short preview what it's going to be about?
Yeah, I will be talking about requirements engineering for agile automotive development. The background of that is that I see a lot of automotive companies claiming that requirements engineering is their core competence because they're integrating so many parts. Now that they're moving towards agile, there is a bit of a tension, because not every agile team thinks they need requirements.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah? It seems to be a conflict with the agile nature.
Sure.
So if you drop requirements, then where does it lead us? I'm curious about the challenges we need to manage, the requirements-related knowledge we still need to maintain,
mm-hmm.
even though we drop perhaps a few of the traditional ways of documenting requirements.
Mm-hmm.
We'll talk about concrete challenges and some ideas on how to address them.
Well, I wish you a great session later on today, and good feedback, and thank you for your time.
Yeah, thank you.